After studying this module, you will be able to know about significance of caffeine, nicotine and cocaine as common stimulants, their mode of actions and mechanism, screening tests of caffeine, nicotine and cocaine. As the name suggests, stimulants increase alertness, attention and energy, as well as elevate blood pressure, heart rate and respiration. Stimulants historically were used to treat asthma and other respiratory problems, obesity, neurological disorders and a variety of other ailments. But as their potential for abuse and addiction became apparent, the medical use of stimulants began to wane. Now, stimulants are prescribed to treat only a few health conditions, including attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, that is ADHD, narcolepsy, and occasionally depression in those who have not responded to other treatments. In comparison to the sedation-inducing drugs, stimulants largely raise neural activity, which in moderation may not be entirely detrimental. Caffeine can elevate the drowsy driver and patients with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, that is ADHD, or narcolepsy can benefit from appropriate doses of methylphenidate or amphetamine. However, stimulant drugs can distress the delicate neural hemostasis in a healthy individual. Stimulants, principally cocaine and amphetamines, are used recreationally for their excitatory and urogenic properties. In this context, they produce intense, overwhelming and distracting effects. After acute administration, users report feeling elated, powerful, having superior intellect and insight, and strong sexual arousal and stimulation. Time may appear to pass more quickly, speech becomes faster and less coherent, and users can become impatient and agitated, sometimes to the point of violence. These perpetual changes are accompanied by increases in pulse and blood pressure, pupillary dilation, sweating and psychomotor restlessness, manifested as pacing, fidgeting and scratching. Simple reaction time may be improved under the influence of stimulants. But this is only one component of driving. In fact, complex reaction time, which demands impulse control, intelligent decision making and appropriate response may be affected adversely. The intensity of these effects depends on the dose, the route of administration, and to some extent the user's familiarity with and tolerance to the effects of the drug. Unavoidably, these effects, when combined, are detrimental to complex task performance and make drivers less attentive, while the psychomotor excitation demands greater focus on muscle control and vehicle operation. Now, caffeine. Caffeine is said to be the most widely used of all mind-alerting substances in the world. It is obtained mainly from the beans of the coffee plant, that is Coffea arabica. Today, caffeine is consumed not only in the form of coffee, but also as chocolates, cocoa drinks, cola drinks, and tea. Apart from its use as a stimulant, caffeine is also used in combination with various analgesics to increase their potency. Several common pharmaceutical preparations contain varying concentrations of caffeine. Caffeine can improve physical performance in endurance exercise like running, but the effect is less for short bursts of movement such as lifting weights or sprinting. Caffeine's strongest effects are felt for about an hour after taking it, but some effects last for 4 to 6 hours. Caffeine causes increased neuron shocks in the brain, which the pituitary gland perceives as an emergency and therefore causes the adrenal glands to release adrenaline. Caffeine also increases dopamine levels, the neurotransmitter that is affected by drugs like amphetamines and heroin. Obviously, it does this on a much lower level than those drugs, but this may be the source of caffeine's addictive quality. Acute overdoses with caffeine are rare. Most cases of toxicity arise from long-term daily consumption of excessive amounts through beverages or drugs. Next is caffeine dependence syndrome. Daily consumption of small quantities of caffeine, that is 20 to 200 milligrams, produces mild positive effects such as a feeling of well-being, alertness, and energetic temperament, but higher doses result in negative effects. Withdrawal syndrome results from abrupt stoppage of daily caffeine intake, exhibits as headache, which sets in 12 to 24 hours after the last dose of caffeine. Drowsiness, lethargy, impaired concentration, nausea, sweating and blurred vision. There is usually intense craving for caffeine. The most commonly reported withdrawal symptoms are listed below. First is headache, often described as being gradual in development and diffuse, and sometimes throbbing and swear. Next is fatigue, sleepiness or drowsiness, such as sleepy, drowsy or yawning, difficulty concentrating, work difficulty, for example, decreased motivation for task or work, irritability, example is irritable, cross, miserable, decreased well-being or contentedness. Next is depression, example is depressed mood, anxiety, example is anxious or nervous, flu-like symptoms, example nausea, vomiting, muscle aches or stiffness, hot and cold spells, heavy feelings in arms or legs, impairment in psychomotor, vigilance and cognitive performances. Next stimulant is nicotine. Nicotine is used widely throughout the world for its stimulating and relaxing effects. Nicotine is the active chemical constituent in tobacco, which is available in many forms, including cigarettes, chewing tobacco, cigars, and smoking cessation aids such as nicotine gum, electronic cigarettes, etc. Nicotine is a colorless to pale yellow, very hygroscopic, oily liquid with an unpleasant pungent odor and sharp, burning, persistent taste. It gradually becomes brown on exposure to air or light. Nicotine is a stimulant of the central nervous system and is abused widely all over the world in the form of inhalation like cigarette, cigar, pipe and bidi, nasal insufflation like snuffing or chewing. Nicotine is also used as insecticide. By far, the commonest source of nicotine poisoning, acute or chronic, results from the smoking tobacco in form of cigarettes. When a cigarette is lit and inhaled, the smoker is exposed to both gaseous and particulate matter. Nicotine and tar are part of the particulate phase of cigarette smoke. The usual nicotine content of a regular cigarette varies between 13 and 20 mg, while certain European and Turkish cigarettes can contain higher amounts. Low nicotine cigarettes contain 7 to 10 mg of the alkaloid. Cigars contain 15 to 40 mg of nicotine. When a cigarette is smoked, more than half the nicotine escapes in the side stream smoke, while a large fraction remains in the butt and filter. And it is only 0.5 to 2 mg, that is average 1 mg of nicotine, that finally is delivered to the smoker. Smoke from non-filtered cigarettes contains slightly higher amounts of nicotine. In India, bidis are very popular, especially among the indigent sections of society, since they are cheaper than cigarettes. They are more harmful than cigarettes and produce higher levels of carbon monoxide, nicotine and tar. After cigarettes, the next common source of nicotine toxicity results from smokeless tobacco, which is of two kinds, snuff and chewing tobacco. The nicotine dissolves in the saliva and is absorbed through the mucous membrane of the mouth as well as through the intestinal mucosa after the saliva is swallowed. Nicotine is a tertiary amine composed of a pyridine and a pyrrolidine ring. Nicotine binds to acetylcholine receptors at ganglia and neuromuscular junctions and in the brain. In its non-ionized form, nicotine freely permeates membranes, including the buccal mucosa and the blood-brain barrier. As a weak base, nicotine is less ionized and penetrates membranes more easily in alkaline solutions. Chewing tobacco and snuff, as well as nicotine gum, are buffered to an alkaline pH to facilitate absorption of nicotine. Fatal dose of nicotine. Nicotine is highly toxic. 2 to 5 mg can cause nausea and 40 to 60 mg can cause death. However, survival has occurred with the ingestions of 1 to 4 grams also. Next is mode of action. Nicotine binds stereospecifically to select acetylcholine receptors, that is nicotine receptors. These receptors are present throughout the body, particularly in the autonomic ganglia, adrenal medulla, central nervous system, spinal cord, neuromuscular junctions and chemoreceptors of carotid and aortic bodies. In the central nervous system, the highest concentration of nicotine receptors is found in the limbic system, midbrain and brainstem. At moderate doses, nicotine stimulates the reticular activating system, producing an alerting pattern on the EEG with resultant favorable effects on memory and attention. Next are the tests for nicotine. Nicotine is isolated by alkaline distillation. The distillate is collected in ice-cold condition in 10 ml of 10% hydrochloric acid. It is made alkaline and extracted 4 times with 10 ml portions of diethyl ether. The ether extracts are combined and dried over anhydrous sodium sulfate. The extract is kept reserved for the following tests. First test is Rosen's test. To the etheryl extract, 1 ml of ether solution of iodine is added. A brownish-red amorphous precipitate is formed, which turns to crystalline ruby-red needle-shaped crystals after some time, indicating the presence of nicotine. Next is Schindelmister test. A portion of ethereal extract is evaporated to dryness. To the residue, 1 drop of 30% formaldehyde solution, which is free from formic acid, and a drop of concentrated sulfuric acid are added. The mixture becomes rose red, confirming the presence of nicotine. Next stimulant is cocaine. Cocaine is a natural alkaloid derived from coca. The dried leaves of the plant Erythroxylum coca, a shrub that grows well in South America, Mexico, Indonesia and West Indies. Chemically, cocaine is benzoyl methyl econine and belongs to the tropane family of natural alkaloids, other members of which include atropine and scopolamine. It occurs as colorless to white crystals or white crystalline powder. It has unpleasant taste and used as local anesthetic. The common ways to intake are chewing, application to nasal mucous membrane, that is snorting, smoking and intravenous injection. Cocaine is usually abused either by chewing coca leaves or smoking coca paste or snorting cocaine hydrochloride. The last mention is the most popular form of cocaine intake. That is, the drug is inhaled in powder form through the nostrils. Occasionally, cocaine hydrochloride is injected intravenously. Today, a smokable form of cocaine, that is crack or rock, has virtually become a rage in the West. Pure alkaloidal cocaine, that is free base or baseball, can also be smoked. Occasionally, coca paste or cocaine sulfate, that is cocaine based pasta or bazooka, is smoked. Cocaine freebase is prepared from cocaine hydrochloride by extracting the cocaine with an alkaline solution buffered with ammonia and adding a solvent such as ether or acetone. Physiological effects of cocaine include increased blood pressure and heart rate, dilated pupils, insomnia, and loss of appetite. The widespread abuse of highly pure street cocaine has led to many severe adverse health consequences such as cardiac arrhythmias, ischemic heart conditions, sudden cardiac arrest, convulsions, strokes, and death. In some users, the long-term use of inhaled cocaine has led to a unique respiratory syndrome, and chronic snorting of cocaine has led to the erosion of the upper nasal cavity. Street names are Coke, Snow, Cardiac, and White Lady. Fatal doses, about 500 mg if taken orally, about 100 mg if it is mucosal contact. Lethal blood level is from 0.2 mg per 100 ml. A very important note, chronic users of cocaine can tolerate much higher doses. Next is metabolism of cocaine. The ability to measure concentrations of cocaine in body fluids can contribute substantially to an investigation of cocaine's pharmacological effects. Strategy of research which involves the administration of cocaine must take into account current knowledge regarding the drug's pharmacokinetics. Cocaine's very rapid elimination from the body should be considered in attempting to understand patterns of cocaine abuse and acute tolerance. Accurate analysis of cocaine or its metabolites is essential to the diagnosis and evaluation of cocaine use, whether for medical or forensic purposes. Appropriate selection of methods for analysis of cocaine depends upon the intended purpose of the assay and correct interpretation of the data obtained upon knowledge of cocaine's kinetics and metabolic disposition. Cocaine is metabolized by liver esterases and plasma cholinesterase to ECNO-9-methyl ester, that is EME, one of the major metabolites, while non-enzymatic hydrolysis results in the formation of the other major metabolite benzoyl ECO-9, that is BE. Minor metabolites include norcocaine, ECO-9, ECONIDINE, noregnodine, methyl ester, noregnonine methyl ester, and M-hydroxybenzoyl ECO-9. Next are the tests for cocaine. First is the Scott test. The residue of the extract is taken in a test tube. 5 drops of 2% cobalt thiocyanate solution prepared by dissolving 2 grams of cobalt thiocyanate in water and diluted with 96% glycerin in the proportion water is to glycerin in the ratio of 1:1. The mixture is shaken and a blue color develops at once, which indicates the presence of cocaine. In the same way, methaqualone also gives a positive reaction. If a blue color develops, 1 drop of concentrated hydrochloric acid is added. The blue color disappears and a pink color appears. If a blue color does not disappear, 1 drop of concentrated hydrochloric acid is again added. Then a few drops of chloroform are added and shaken. The chloroform layer becomes intense blue. Next is gold chloride test. 1 drop of 5% gold chloride solution in water is added to a few drops of extract. A precipitate is formed which appears as desiccate, rosette, or long rod shaped crystal under the microscope. The precipitate is also insoluble in dilute hydrochloric acid. Next is ethyl benzoate test. Take appropriate amount of suspected sample and moistened with nitric acid. Evaporate to dryness. Add few drops of alcoholic potash. Odor of ethyl benzoate indicates positive test for the presence of cocaine. Next is crystal test. To the dried residue of the extract or sample, a few drops of saturated solution of alum and one drop of saturated potassium permanganate are added successively with stirring. It is placed on a microscopic slide and covered with cover slip. Under microscope, distinctive rectangular pink color crystals are observed. This shows the presence of cocaine. We'll conclude this module with the summary. Tobacco abuse has been described as being the most pervasive cause of death and disability worldwide than any single disease entity. Environmental tobacco smoke, that is ETS, consists of mainstream smoke, sidestream smoke and vapor phase components that diffuse through cigarette paper into the environment. ETS exposure occurs frequently in the home, in the workplace and in other public areas where smoking is allowed. In the current drug subculture, cocaine has become the champagne drug because of its cost and relative scarcity. Cocaine is a rich man's drug. Since the poorer classes cannot afford to sustain a drug habit that costs thousands of rupees every week. Therefore, in India, cocaine abuse is restricted mainly to the affluent classes of society. Drug habituation is a condition resulting from the continued consumption of a drug, which does not cause much harm to the individual or to the society, though there is a psychological and emotional dependency on the drug. These are caffeine, nicotine, etc. Caffeine prompts the body to lose water through urination. This can lead to dehydration and is the reason that caffeinated drinks are not a good idea when working out or doing other activities that require fluids. Caffeine was formerly available in combination with phenyl propanol amine and ephedrine in formulations designed to mimic controlled stimulants. This combination was declared irrational by the FDA in USA in August 1982 and removed from the market. Caffeine, even in low doses, may increase alertness, and this is readily apparent in low arousal situations, whereas high doses of caffeine can lead to increased anxiety in some individuals.